So the first 5 episodes of Rise of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles have been out online for quite some time now. Well, for whatever reason, they decided to go out of order and skip episode 2B, titled Donnie's Gifts, and release episode 4A instead. But regardless of that, thoughts and opinions of all kinds have been coming from all sides of the internet. In short, I think Rise is going to be great. It will find its audience quickly once it debuts on TV in mid-September, and will probably last just as long as the 2012 series did. It's a bold new take on TMNT, heavily straying away from a lot of the default templates that we are accustomed to. Let's discuss the stories, plots, characters, and whatever else comes to my head through this huge sample size that we have. Firstly, let's run down each episode that we've seen. I've got a couple episode reviews already uploaded, and plenty more on the way. Mystic Mayhem was a fantastic debut episode, clocking in at 22 minutes long like we're used to. Even though it's 22 minutes long, the episode's pace is still very fast. A lot of people say the episodes feel rushed, but that's modern kids' cartoons for you. They're fun and keep the action and comedy going fast. Kids have short attention spans now, and cartoon stations have tried combating that with fast-paced shows. The episode can quickly be summarized as the Turtles and April are already best friends, they meet Mayhem, the mystic cat thing, we see Splinter and his new personality, and then the Turtles are led to the underground city deep under New York. They get their mystic weapons, but Donnie refuses his, they find Baron Draxum, witness the first mutation of the series, fight Draxum, technically defeat him, and the Ooskitos are all released into New York in the process. This episode plot was actually great, it felt important, but things gradually fizzle out through these 5 episodes. Next up, we have Origami Tsunami, and I think everyone agrees that this is the second best episode thus far. The Turtles discover the Foot Lieutenant and the Foot Brute, along with Origami Soldiers. There's a lot of comedy and hijinks going on through this episode, until the Turtles fight the Foot. The Foot end up escaping, and that was that. I thought the comedy in this episode was hysterical. This show takes comedy to a whole new level with TMNT. A lot of the concepts and stories are so far-fetched and out of this world that you just have to laugh, but I love it. We never got episode 2B, for whatever reason, so next is War and Pizza. This episode revolves around April and the villain Alberto. Alberto turns evil after Donnie fixes him up, along with other Chuck E. Cheese-like characters, like President Pepperoni. The Turtles and April defeat Alberto, and April gets fired for destroying the building. This episode was our first real taste of filler. The only big things to come out of this episode were the debut of Alberto, and the possible start to April's job-searching saga. I have a feeling April is going to have like 6, 7, maybe even 8 jobs on her resume by the end of this series. But regardless, this episode was fun, and it had its great moments. Next up, we have Newsworthy. It starts out weird with a monologue from a new villain, Warren Stone. It goes over off-camera battles the Turtles have had, unless of course they took place in episode 2B, which we haven't seen yet. But I suspect that episode 2B is the Meat Sweats episode. A shocking part to this episode was when Leo cut him right in half, but it was covered up by the fact that he can regenerate his body. After some silliness, the episode concludes with a battle against the Turtles, Stone, and another new villain, Hypnopotamus. This episode wasn't anything special, but I still think it was pretty entertaining. I love Warren Stone, and Hypnopotamus was a nice addition as well. And lastly, we got Repo Mantis. This episode is centered solely on Donnie and Mikey, which was cool. You can assume episode 4B will center around Leo and Raph. The Turtles go on a repo mission to be awarded with some space cruiser from a movie with like 60 sequels. After meeting with Todd, a mutant woodchuck, they somehow build him an amusement park of a house in exchange for his overdue trailer. The Turtles try to trade the trailer in exchange for the space cruiser, but Repo Mantis, the junkyard owner, ripped them off, and the Turtles ended up getting away with the cruiser. This was probably the least entertaining episode for me so far, but that doesn't mean it was bad. We get to see Donnie and Mikey off on their own, which is always cool. It's always awesome to see in a Turtle series how each brother will act when they're only with another brother. Repo Mantis is pretty cool. I like his shtick. A New York cheapskate. And Todd, well, he was funny, but any more episodes with him could get very tiring. Now that we've discussed the episodes, there are some characters that need to be addressed. Let's address the elephant in the room here. Master Splinter. He's so much different from any other version of him that we've ever seen, and many think it's a bad change. And well, I'd be lying if I didn't say it was a bad change. But he will not remain this way for too long. After season 1 is over, I expect Splinter to start slimming down, becoming more strict, and training much more. An evil will be coming sometime throughout the series that forces him to channel his inner true self. I know, nobody wants to see this fat, grumpy, ugly Splinter watch cartoons every episode. I know I sure don't. But just give it time, everyone. With a little time, I'm sure a lot of you guys will find that this Splinter is actually hilarious, because he really is.
And I thought purple was the funny one.
And then there's April O'Neil, the other highly criticized character. It's funny, so much hate came out when her official design was revealed, and then everything died down. But ever since these sneak peeks have been released, along with her character bio video, the hate has been resurrected. I really don't understand this hate like I do Splinter's. Some people just really hate the change. I don't think that her skin color is what most people dislike. It's her wild personality. This new April is fun, brave, and honestly reminds you a little bit of Casey Jones. She's definitely not the smart young woman that we're used to, but it still works for me. The Turtles have all been pretty well received as far as I can tell. Donnie and Leo are definitely the fan favorites so far, but Raphael and Mikey have their fans as well. Donnie is fantastic. Him and Leo are my two favorites. This Donnie is really funny, and his battle shell combined with his tech bow turned him into possibly the most powerful turtle on the team. Seriously, watch these episodes. Donnie was the closest one to taking out Baron Draxum. He's really snarky, but still sometimes shows his insecure side as well. Leonardo is just hysterical. We all know this one. A lot of people don't like Raph being leader. But Leo has shown the most leadership skills out of all of the guys, and is on the fast track to becoming the official leader sometime after season 1. This Leo is definitely the funniest one ever, and probably the funniest turtle ever. His comedy is so much more than just his one-liners. His timing is perfect, and his voice actor, Ben Schwartz, nails every line. He's definitely skilled too, showing he can be the all-around ninja that we all want to see. Raphael is probably my least favorite turtle so far, but that's definitely not the fault of him being leader or his voice. It's actually his lines. I don't know, swooping in like a boss just hasn't grown on me yet, and neither have his other lines. Jumping Jack Flash is pretty funny though. I think Raphael will improve as the series goes on, especially once he is dethroned as leader. Hopefully that will light a fire in him and make him more like the Raphael that we all know. And lastly, Michelangelo. I thought I was going to hate this Mikey, but he's actually great. The way that they're making him and portraying him as the youngest brother is fantastic. I thought he was going to be way too kiddy and childish when the first trailers dropped, but I am eating those words now. For this series, they're writing him perfectly so far. And then there are the villains. The main villains that we've seen so far are Repo Mantis, Warren Stone, Alberto, the Foot Lieutenant, the Foot Brute, Hypnopotamus, and Baron Draxum. Draxum is obviously the favorite so far. He is diabolical, but at the same time a little whimsical. His backstory with the Turtles is one of the most anticipated parts of this show. The other villains are nothing big. The Foot Brute and Lieutenant are my next favorites, followed by Stone, Hypnopotamus, Repo, and lastly, Alberto. Hopefully, as these villains make more appearances as the episodes come out, they have some deeper meanings and motivations to their actions. But who knows, I suspect a lot of these villains stay one-dimensional, at least the ones like Alberto and the other random mutants. Finally, let's discuss some of the storylines and plots. The Turtles' original weapons were a hot topic leading up to these episodes. So many theories were being stated by fans. I like the idea of them discovering these mystic weapons, but I think that they should save them for the bigger moments. Instead, we haven't seen their original weapons since midway through the first episode, besides Donnie, of course. One day, I'm sure we will see Donnie's mystic weapon in action. And what's up with Mayhem? We saw it a lot through episode 1. Hell, Mayhem is the first thing that we see in the first scene of the show. Now we haven't seen it since. Did April just disown the thing off screen? If they're going to introduce Mayhem as some mysterious, important little mutant, why just forget about it after it becomes April's pet? I think that the comedy is fantastic. Most of the writing is really good, and most of the jokes have me laughing out loud. These turtles are really lovable. They don't skip out on the action either. The fights so far have resulted in the turtles being defeated most of the time, but they have had their moments as well. By the end of season 1, I'm sure these turtles are going to have their mystic weapons mastered and be pretty lethal ninjas. And how crazy is it that this series just jumps right into things? The turtles are already best friends with April, the first time that we see her. That's definitely a first. I like the Ooskitos, and it is kind of funny to see them in the background in scenes, like the segment of the hippo and the magician in the beginning of Newsworthy. But so far, they have not utilized them other than being a cheap way to make a bunch of random villains for the filler episodes. Hopefully, they are more explored as the episodes come out.
You follow us? This part hurts! That hurts!
There is no possible way for you to deny that this show is perfect for the modern audience. Kids are going to eat this show up, making it last for probably 5 seasons, at least. Just imagine how redeeming it's going to be for us fans who stuck with this series. Leo will be the leader, Splinter will be closer to his normal self, and maybe even the Shredder. I did a lot of talking here, and I'm sure I forgot to talk about some topics, but I've covered a lot. Tell me your opinions on Rise through the first 5 episodes in the comments down below, and subscribe for more, everybody. Peace out.
So, you guys from Jersey?